Hello everyone, and welcome to the first match of Chains of Small Combo. We do have mana, and we have defense grid, we're lacking lands, and we're lacking a combo, so maybe this was supposed to be a mulligan. Alright, playing against the Mother of the Runes. Okay, good to know. People are not loading the picture, but keep on playing here. Alright, I think I have enough lands, so I'll bottom pedal, but I do need an actual land here. Yeah. Do I want to play this Lotus Petal? I think I might. They have, Thalia. They have Revoker. Yeah, I can name the petal now, but, that means they don't name Wishclaw Talisman, so that's okay. Okay, Stoneforge Mystic. That is fine. They will put up a clock on me with a Kadra Complete, maybe. Yeah, they do. And boom. Water comes through. Draw with a Bloom Apprentice. Very good. I want to kick things off with a Brainstorm. Yeah. Okay, now I regret having kept that land, but I know I was going to draw a million lands there. So I'll put these two top, play land. I have to shuffle. The question is, do I want to play a defense grid now using the pedal? I think I might. At the end of the day, I have lots of lands. Defense grid kind of helped me to play around Solitude, so I can just play that in the same turn so that I might play around Skeklive Operation. I have so much mana that I think I can easily do that, I think. Yeah, unfortunately, maybe though, if I draw a Wishclaw Talisman, I don't know if I have that much mana. Okay, Urza Saga. And you put into play the Kadra Complete, and you can attack me for, I don't know, 5 or 6, you do. Or 6. Okay, I'll fetch on the turn, and I hope to top deck Chainsaw Smog. That's the combo right there if I draw it. If I don't draw it, there's no combo right there. I'm on 12. Yeah, I'm dead in 2, so I definitely cannot afford to cast a Witherbloom Apprentice. I have to save it all. Actually, let me think about it. If I draw with a Bloom Apprentice, what's the word? The 2 mana, Wishclaw Talisman. Next turn I have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'll need 3, 5, 7, 9. So yeah, I can play everything in the same turn. Of course, assuming they don't play that. Good, okay, yeah. You don't need to tell. Okay. This is maybe a point as no, this is sorcery. Sorry, it is an instance you can make in your opponent's turn as well. Okay, I'm taking 5, 7. That's lethal, so I'll have to draw the thing now or else I'm dead. And I don't want to erase cast it, so I just thin the deck. And I hope to top deck. But I will definitely play around Doomsday for the next game since I just can't draw. Let's say draw Chains of Smog now. Boom! The land. Yep, that's unfortunately how the combo decks work. Yeah, maybe the Brewer should have bottomed everything. It's just that I had only one land. I was very afraid of them wastelanding it, you know? So I was like, I want at least a second land. And all I knew is that I drew mono land. Okay, this one doesn't help. Since, yeah. Okay, now we sideboard against Death and Tax. So there's 5 things. This one helps you to play around Plow. I think I want to take out a couple of Defense Grid. Maybe one, yeah. I definitely want to get rid of Duresses. If they only had plow, maybe duress would have been slightly better than good grid, but the fact that they have also solitude means that I just need the grid, in my opinion. And yeah, basically my opponent did their thing, I did my thing, and they put a clock on me. Stoneforge Mystic does that, it must be said. With since they had Kadra complete, you know, before Battleskull would have been so much slower. They would have needed to take the Sword of Fire and Ice for sure before Kadra complete. The fact that you have 80 cards, it means that you're less likely to draw the complete, means that Stoneforge Mystic is better. Stoneforge decks, yeah, the more cards you play, the better it gets. You can even play more target. Like complete, Battleskull, Jit, and the Sword. Which is definitely too many for a normal deck. Okay, we're starting here. That will reveal their Yorion. I'll go ahead and keep my hand here. Do I want to play Island? It's not ideal since the combo requires a lot of... since Recombo requires a lot of black mana, but since I have so many blue cantrips, I am desperate. Ooh, there it is. That's the whole thing. Very good. I can't go off on... Oh yeah, I can. With Summoner's Pact, I can go off on turn 2. Yep, that's it. I don't have double black. Unfortunately, because Summoner's Pact can go get your... green mana, but I don't have double black for next turn. I need a polluted delta. Awkward. Okay, then. I want to play this. So if I crack the pedal to play a Preordain, I can draw the Swamp, but then I don't have the fourth land next turn. So I feel like I have to pass. Yeah, I feel like I didn't have a way to win on turn 2, unfortunately. They play Aether Vial. Again, sorry for the pictures not loading. Now, I might find like a, what's it called, Dark Ritual on top of my deck, and then I would win, I think. So let's do that with a Ponder. What's the worst thing that can happen this turn? They play Athalia, I need 5 lands, and I do have them next turn. I guess not really, because Summoner's Pact isn't a land. Do I want to play Wishclaw Talisman? Let's say I go pick up the Wishclaw Talisman with a Polluted Delta on top. I go Forest, crack the pedal, Wishclaw Talisman. Then I draw the Polluted Delta. The Talisman can go get Dark Ritual. Then I have the combo. Probably even through Athalia. Because I have these 2 mana here. I use 1 to get Dark Ritual. I use this Delta to get Dark Ritual. No, I don't have enough, I think. I don't have enough, I think. Okay, then. I'm just drawing the Polluted Delta. Might even play in it, honestly. Or I can crack it for a Preordain Underground Sea. I do need double black to combo, so maybe I should just pass here. Maybe I should just pass here. Yeah, I think it's the safest. It is the safest. Consider that they might have a solitude to blow up my combo, so I might not even like 100% sure about winning the game. Maybe I was supposed to get Preordain here. Very tricky. Very tricky to play against Death and Taxes. You don't exactly know what to expect every time. Sure, yeah, they basically don't have much, but going to fetch here. Yeah, I think I do. Look at the Swamp here. Draw. Yeah, this does nothing. Well, so I could win the game, but I would lose to a solitude. Like, actual lose. Like, I would lose my whole land, would lose the game if that's solitude. Now, the question is, do I want to give them the option to just untap and they have like 3 mana plus bile? Or do I want to just close my eyes and do the thing? Let's see. All right, they did an F6. That's a check you can do on Magic Online. Because they pass me priority. Now, obviously, that might be like a bait. It doesn't necessarily mean that they have the solitude. The thing is that if I go priority, what am I looking at? Just very few things that saves me from solitude. I think I have to go for it, and I'll lose the game. That's it. Yeah. Wow, they conceded. All right, good. Good today. Good today. Good that I went for it. Since now you have the combo, you can target yourself, you keep on draining, and you win the game. Okay. Maybe they even brought out Solitude because they thought I was Doomsday. I haven't thought about that option. Yeah, that definitely could have happened. That definitely could have happened. Yeah, I am submitting the same list, I believe. Would have been very bad by me to pass the turn there, I'm pretty sure. They are now trying to figure out whether they. I mean, they definitely need Solitude and Plow, I think, against this combo. Maybe I do need all the defense. Okay, let's go. Darth Dog. I just thought about it now. Summoner's Pact could have also gotten me Sylvan Safekeeper to play around Plow. Yeah, and Solitude. Yeah, that's an important thing. I didn't think about it. Of course, inexperience, first time playing the deck, blah blah blah. I think it was still correct to go off because I assume my opponent probably assumed that was Doomsday, so they didn't have any removal. But in game three, our Summoner's Pact can also go get Sylvan Safekeeper. Okay. Well, we have a lot of cyber cards that. Oh wow, Wasteland, very scary. I should have preordained immediately. I find Defense Grade and Polluted Delta. I definitely like the. Yeah, I think I like both of these cards. Opponent? Yeah, I'll play Petal. My opponent, if they play Revoker, they will name Petal anyway, so might as well just play the Petal. Remember to just Wasteland in your own. No reason to Wasteland and. Okay, I'll draw the defense grid, which I think it's important. Now I'll play Land and Pass. I don't need to play Brainstorm, and I don't need to just play dual land. What's a saga, okay. Let's see if they play Athalia. I can't consider going Brainstorm. Athalia. I can consider going Brainstorm. But I think I will decide not to. Tap. Okay. I'll go get, I believe, a swamp here. And an island. And then I want to Fatal Push this immediately. Because this way they can't draw a Karakas to save it. Again, this defense grade might have been wrong. I'm just a little bit afraid of removal spell. I'm playing against white. It's just, yeah, should win my turn, but it does not really matter much. Okay, Summoner's Pact. What do I want to do? Do I want to cast this Brainstorm? Well, I might win the game if I find good things here. So yeah, I think I'll play Brainstorm. Okay. I'm looking for Chain of Smog now, so I'll bottom one summoner's pact. What else do I want to bottom here? Maybe a Fade Up push. I'll just keep the Abrupt Decay around. I just bottom both summoners pact, honestly. If they have the defense grid, likely that I guess maybe it's just defense grid the card to bottom here. Because I have the Sylvan Safekeeper. Yeah, I believe so actually. Not pass. I'm looking for well, a Chain of Smog. Or a Witch Blood Talisman. I don't have that much mana. I'll have to fetch. Look at a green land. Probably a buff. Because they can't get Pithing Needle and name my Polluted Delta. Do it again. I don't know if there's like any artifact that just shut me up. Wow, they got Shadows. Weird. I think I'll kill a construct. Just because I have nothing much to do. With an Abrupt Decay or with a Fatal Push? Does it matter? Fatal Push is cheaper and I don't. So maybe I want to hold it, but I don't really have much to do with my mana. Okay, come on. Let's draw a Chain of Smog. Don't. Because with the Boom Apprentice then. Vial goes up. I have five cards in hand. I like to play this. Even playing this doesn't have a picture. Come on, man. All right, yeah, the good thing of playing this is that my opponent kind of has to like do something so they don't make constructs and blah blah blah. I think I gain a lot of turns by casting that my apprentice. Of course, I wouldn't have cast another one if I didn't have it in hand. And I don't want to cast this because this one can get me the Sylvan Safekeeper to combo safely. All right, come on, Chain of Smog. Witch Call Talisman. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I want to go Witch Call Talisman and crack it immediately. Again, I can't win the game this turn, but I definitely want to crack this now. And like, they can do everything nasty, of course, but I feel like I have to cash in my Demonic Tutor there. These constructs are large. Ooh, Wasteland. That's annoying because that means I can't go off with a protection. Because I needed 5 mana next turn to play Sylvan Safekeeper and this and that. So we'll see. They even have Talisman that I can use, but if they use it, then I can get Dark Ritual. They have the Aether Vial, so. Yeah, can flow like a black mana, although I'm not going to use it because the petal is very much needed now. I guess I wish I had that fatal push now, huh? Would have killed the construct and got it. But like not that it matters. Alright, let's see what happens now. They have three cards in hand, but they have the talismans. Are they violating something? It's not. There it is. Still land is fine. Summoner's spell costs one mana. So if I this is the Thalia. The thing is that if they tutor up the Thalia with the talisman, I get a talisman. So it can pay one to get Dark Ritual. And I would have won. Actually I wouldn't. That cost. Wouldn't have done it regardless, since they wasteland. Alright, yeah, I don't think I have an out now. You can go with the Apprentice back to crack the pedal. And they're like, I don't have a... Yeah, no, that's it. Thalia lock. Alright, good game. I needed I need to find a Chainless Mog. I found a Wish Club. I guess I did find it, but they just closed it. Alright. Go game 3. I'll be on... No, when's the match? Sorry, I lost. Forgot. I lost the game before this. Alright, but then for round number 2. It's round number 2. We have a half over combo, and we'll do the digging for the next half. When it's playing Island Ponder here. All good, all good. And I'm deciding whether I want to keep things off with a duress, or just go look for that brainstorm, since next turn I can't win the game, plus having the duress backup. And I think I'll go for that. I guess I'll ponder, that's even better. I can pick up the island tube, since I don't think I need green mana. I already have a spirit guide. I'm just gonna go basically copy my opponent and ponder. Looking for Chainsaw Smog, there it is. I have defense grid and I have Elvish Spirit Guide. I like all of these cards here. Let me draw it. I wanted to stock up on those, because next turn I want to go, we'll see what they do, but like I can pay for days, that's why I stock up on those. Like next turn I want to go maybe like a Dark Ritual Duress, then I have the 2 black left, so I can go for with my Apprentice's Chainsaw Smog, paying for the at least one day. And if I see too many things going on, I have that defense grid on top of my deck. They go ponder, not shuffle. And yeah, I'm gonna go Dark Ritual. It might seem like I'm wasting the Dark Ritual, but the thing is that if this like works, I win the game. We're playing a combo deck. I'm happy to just do this. Wow, sneak attack. If Seaman Spirit Geiger is a brand, alright, cool. So, Witherbloom Apprentice. I don't play Chainsaw. They said, oh no. That's over. Okay. We did the thing. Azorius turn 2 with protection. Alright, find the combo deck is good. Go to the sideboard, playing a Sneak and Show. What do I want against Sneak and Show? Probably Philosopher's Storm. Age stops Sneak Attack, but I don't know. Not sure. Sylvan Safekeeper doesn't seem great. Yeah, every Philosopher's Storm and Defense Grade in the same deck is kind of weird, but. Definitely needed, I think. I want something else here. I don't want something else. Maybe Xanthus Worm is also good. Taking out the speed. Am I taking out the consistency? Maybe defense grid is slightly worse than yeah. We have to do something like this. Bit of Summer is basically a defense grid. But it makes you so that you can still cast Lost Storm. And I need to cut 2 more cards. Yeah, I can honestly get rid of those. Because like, against Death and Toxins, I think it's fine for you to just tap those immediately. But against combo deck, you can't because they're going to kill you. Alright, let's go with this. Having Defense Grid in the same deck with Flusterstorm, I think it's awkward. And yeah, I think Bill Summer and Flusterstorm might be like that because, well, the Flusterstorm is a defensive counter. So if your opponent plays Show and Tell, you play Flusterstorm. As I said, you don't use it to protect your own combo because that's not how the deck works. All right. This Gend is fine. I don't have the con any pieces of the combo. I have two counters. I love how the chat is just my opponent going, oh no. The mirror match of combo decks and Legacy Tool is like, yeah, just whoever goes first. No, sorry, whoever combos first. Okay, now I believe I just want to go land go here. Just playing it safe with my Flusterstorm. No reason to go to rest. It just brings me in response and combo you the next turn. Even just slamming the Grisabrand, it's like comboing because then the Grisabrand finds the counter spell and blah blah blah. All right, I don't. Flusterstorm is really good against Show and Tell because that means that if your opponent puts Show and Tell on the stop with a Force of Will backup and you play Flusterstorm, there's nothing they can do. Can't save their card. And they can save it with the Flusterstorm. Mana. I have a Elvish Spirit got me. Ooh, Green Lava Monster. Oh my. Ah. Oh. I'm gonna save that point in oh no. Brought out the Sylvan Safe Keeper. Am I just stone dead? Am I B? Oh no. Eat down every spirit guide. I guess I can kill it, so it's not gonna work either. No, oh, let me just click on the card. I was supposed to go to rest here. Apologize. But I just straight up don't think I can do much better. Let me check my deck. Yeah, I'm dead. I just don't have any out. Or kills my thing, and I guess I need two. If I have two, I don't lose. Okay. Well, I'm not dead. Good to know. Good to know that I'm not dead. I'm just gonna go Trop Go. Unfortunately, I wasted the Dark Rachel, but that was a click. Apologize for that. Yeah, no, taking up Radiator is also red because that means that I would only three. Okay. We continue here. But Ponder because I have a fetch land. Well, Summoner Respect is another combo piece. So I'd love to draw it. Or it's the first combo piece, I would say. I think I want to draw all of these cards. Okay, Shuffle Library now. Pretty sad I wasted a Dark Ritual, but gotta move on now. Draw the Veil of Summer. I know top card is good, it's a brainstorm, so I'm just passing here. It goes sneak attack. It goes sneak attack, I can't do much about it. Alright, now we'll play a Preordain because the top is clean. Okay. Bottom, top. So now I have multiple Withered Apprentice. Remember, I have to cast them in the same turn together with a Chain of Smog. Yeah, the Dark Ritual would have looked very handy, huh? Yeah. For me. I on myself again, week of Yeah, unfortunately, my counter spell don't work against that thing. Razor Brand will come down. I'll draw 14 and then Emrakul. And I'll lose. Now we have to change sideboard approach. Maybe I only need one Sylvan Safekeeper in the main. I only need one Sylvan Safekeeper in the main because yeah, with that one, can play around everything I want. Maybe I wanna cut a Veil of Summer. Maybe I wanna cut the Zant as well. I want Fatal Push or Abrupt. Yeah, I think one Sylvan Safekeeper is enough because they have four summoners pop, they can go get it. Yeah. If I had a Dark Ritual, I could have maybe pushed with the Brainstorm, but I would have still needed like seven mana in the same turn to go off. Okay, yes. Alright, this one doesn't have land, so I'm mulliganing it. I'm keeping this one. Who do I bottom? Veil of Summer, Ritual Talisman. Like the thing is with Ritual Talisman is that it lets you win the game the same turn you're activating it. So I guess it's not like the actual worst. Yeah, probably I'm fine with this. Last year, I'm just going Brainstorm end of turn. Hope no Lavamancer. Brainstorm end of turn, always risky because if there's no land, that's what they call a Brainstorm lock. I don't want to brainstorm again. I'm just going to do rest here. I don't want to go brainstorm again. It's just so risky. I think I'm just playing a duress now. I got Dazzle, Elvish Bird Guide. Pay for it. Hey, they show me their hand. Have to take It's show and tell, but this is going to be tough. Yeah, I wish they had this hand in the previous game. Now, there's no reason for me to sneak attack to duress them again. I had a thought. Let me go. Brainstorm. I do have the combo pieces, but I'm just missing I'm missing lands. Wait, am I missing lands? No, I believe I can win the next turn. But I can't win now. Yeah, I mean I need a land. If it was a land, I could have gone land dark ritual. Elvish Spirit Guide, and then this one would have got the piece combo, the combo piece. Well, that's fine. Let's not lose our hope here, huh? Die. Let's not lose our hope here. Let's just pop these two and pass. If they don't have a dual land, they can't attack with the Emrakul. So if even if they attack with the Emrakul, like I'm not dead here. I'm not gonna concede. Wow, they don't have a land. That means though they probably have a blue card for force. I think I will go to rest here. I could go for the win, but they have that Force of Will in hand. I think I'm gonna go the rest, because that means they have two spell. They don't have any land in hand. Very likely they have a blue card. Oh wow, they could have gone. They could have gone Show and Tell. Or Grisabrand, and then they have infinite counter. Huh. I think I want to just discard Show and Tell again. If I just discard Force and they go Show and Tell Grisabrand, how do I win? It's impossible. They have, access to so many cards to cast Forces. Yeah, I'm discarding Show and Tell again. They don't have a pitch. So I can't do anything here, but that's okay. I can still like. Okay, they passed. What though? Now what though? So close. Because I could go for the win. But if they drew any blue card, I lose because I discard my whole hand. Should I do? I go for it. I wouldn't draw a blue card. Did I play a cantrip? What's the blue card that I could have drawn there? I think I'm going for it. Let me just think in my head that what can I do? A Dark Ritual and Ice Spirit guy. It's 4 mana. This one gets the. Yeah, so I think I'm going. I think I'm going. Oh, if they have a counter here, I'm okay. Days? Days. Okay, wow. Oof. Well, I can pay for the days, but if I do that, I can't do anything, so. That's it. That is resolved, and I'm moving on. If I pay for the days, I can cast a Wishclaw Talisman. Does that change anything if I Wishclaw Talisman in play? Like, the thing is that I could have a Spirit Guide in hand or a Talisman in play. Maybe Talisman in play is good. Let's say I draw land. Yeah, maybe. Maybe it is good. In the talisman in play. I'm already casting this talisman. So pay. Yes. Play talisman path. I don't want to activate it. Me. Play Talisman. Pass. Now. Now, I sort of have the combo. I'm missing like lands and everything. Let's see what they draw. I'm so much not in a good shape here. I lose to like blue cards and lands. I mean, ideally they would have drawn like a Grisabrand or an Emrakul, but they didn't. They're paying a mana cost for what? A Braid? Oh wow, you drew a Show. Yeah, the third Show and Tell. Right. Good game, good game, good game. Close match after all. I'll be back for round number three. Round three, hoping to get that first win. The matches have been close though, and lots of close matches, lots of lost arrows. Oh, that's not a sword. Ooh, is that, oops, the old spells? No. No. Don't do that. Don't do that to me. Can I just win a dart over once? No. Mango 09. I guess I was probably gonna lose to this. That we're just going to go like Dark Rachel death thing and then it's over. Yeah, it's over. Over. It's over for your friend the Mango 09. They did a mistake and targeted themselves. And as a result, they did win them the game with Narcomoebas and blah blah blah. All right. Okay. At least it's quick. You can say that. Watch this video when I go 0-3 drop and be like, oh, this was a quick match, man. I wonder how you did. All right, that's not being negative, huh? I have a lot of stuff. Grids, I'll take out the Sylvan Safe Keeper. I'll definitely keep Duresses. Two cards to cut. I want more redundancy. I want to cut redundancy. They're probably good even to just get the cage. Right. Are they good to get the cage? We don't. Let's go. We're in the play, so. Oops, those spells. What a deck. Right, so this hand can win on turn two if I draw exactly. Yeah, I'll keep it. Duress. And I have a. So do I want to go ponder? Actually. Now, you know what? Let's just go Duress. And if I need to, I can go Petal Ponder. What a strong hand my opponent opened there. Oof. Actually, not really. If I take the Petal, they don't have anything going. They don't even have any black mana. Okay, it's not as strong. I thought it was a black mana, but it's green. So yeah, I just take the Petal, and my opponent is unable to do anything meaningful. Pretty big fan of that. I'm also casting. No, I think that's Petal. They have Thoughtseize Kabar Therapy. No, yeah, it's fine to me. I'm just chilling now. She looks like a green card that exiles for free. Endurance? Maybe I should play one Endurance. Last. Summoner's Pact and doesn't do it. Still missing that. Remember, Summoner's Pact can go get only Withermer Apprentice and Seamless Spirit and Every Spirit. I'll go get the Trop. Colors. No. Okay, come on, change those mods. None of these I'll shuffle. Change those mods. Oop, there it is. Oop, there it is. All right, we got it. Petal. Two Seamless, two Seamless, two Heavy Spirit Guide. I think we have it. All right. Cast. Heavy Spirit Guide. Cast. Heavy Spirit Guide. Petal. Exile. Exile. Withermer Apprentice. Chain of Smog. Victory. You wish to cope with the spell? I do wish. Same target, thanks. And then you continue. Okay, this was a good turn two win. With a lucky chain of small. I mean, we're confident. We need to top that. We need to get lucky. That's it. Like, it's not that. That's it. Like, there's just no way to play around that. So, as I said, no endurance. I mean, having endurance in this deck is kind of wild. Like, you have no green mana. Sure, you can get Pond Summoner's Pact. Yeah, but like you have to pay for the echo cost afterwards. They probably lose the game. Yeah, no, that's cool. Let's just go and like hope to draw, I guess, a plus a surgical. They combo turn one. Kind of a sad life to live against this of soul cells. But that is the life of playing without forces. Okay, so this end is the combo. See how much the Mulligan dealt. If the Mulligan dealt to 3, I guess. I don't know. They kept 7. No, no way I can keep. Alright, I'll keep this and. Again, I can't Mulligan to find exactly surgical. Even if I play like Cabal Therapy and Thoughtseize. So I'll keep this and. And if they win on turn 1, that's it. Good game. Shake hands virtually, of course. If not, I have a good hand. This hand is. Age, there's the Wither Apprentice, there's the Duress. Probably we're not gonna be able to cast any of these cards and will be sad, although I'll probably play the 4th. Hope they kept just a slow hand, the slow things. That doesn't sound slow. If you play Summoner Spock, let me tell you, usually game ends. And again, if I had Endurance, sure, I could do that. But I die now. How did you do that? Oh, okay. Do you target myself? They target themselves. They're very good. Okay, I guess if you really want a combo deck, maybe my opponent's one is probably better than this. Oh, that sucks. Maybe they cut. Wait, where's the top? What about return? Yes, I voted out. All right, well done, opponent. You win. Good game. I'll play the 4th round. These games are quick. Let's play a 4th round. If you're that brave to go down there. Okay, I'm round 5, and I did a very bold play of restarting Magic Online. And what happens is that I thought that it would load the picture better, but instead it just lost them all. So we're gonna give you a little bit of what was when I grew up playing Magic. I used to play on a Magic Workstation because they didn't have money to play Magic Online, and I also didn't have enough data to download the arts. So this was my experience when I just started to play Magic in my first days. You know what I have in it, right? You know it. I have a Chainsmog's reading here. Chainsmog, Wither Apprentice, Yoshibukai, Summoner Spock. Arts? Well, we know that it's made by Anna. Actually, even read that. Yeah, no arts. No. Oh, I think some arts are coming. The datas all the way from Renton, Washington are coming to Senegalia. Oh, an alien. The alien. We see this art clearly now. We're getting all the arts. We are getting all the arts. I was going to combo turn 2, just to make it short, but guess what? I drew my cards, so funny. Ooh, even Wither Apprentice. Okay, all the cards appeared. Now, we all know this beautiful picture. This person's mugging from the ears. Okay, where's the stuff? Fine. Nothing else to do. I'm tapping and drawing here. Well, I still don't have protections from a Force of Will, so I think I have to kill. Especially if they decide. I'll keep on drawing lands here. I want to just make my opponent discard 2 cards. They copy it. By discarding 2 cards, yeah, I don't. I'm great. I'm just playing a land and passing again. I have to crack up my land in case they have a Pithing Needle in the main. The saga. But it basically can't go off. I'm not sure what's the problem here, because my connection is fine. I really don't know what's the problem. Why the pictures don't load. Guess it's something like to empty the cache. The internet very well. Alright, let's go get my lands here. I'm gonna get the swamp, forest, and I'm gonna get. There's a saga results and goes get probably a retrieve the foundry. Less shutter speed. Wandering hand. Double pair. Problem with the double pair is that it doesn't matter because if I put two of these into play, just force to fill my chainless mog and I lost my hand, then I lose the game. So it doesn't really matter that I have a double pair. Not the best, not the best, not the best. Okay. On 8. Yeah, play one of these. Well, I could die to a burn spell now. I feel like I have to play at least one. And I guess I'm going to burn in a response, sure. In two with this. I'll play with a Bloom Apprentice. And then I'll play Chainos. Targeting me. But I don't die to single removal, but I of course die to a four. This one cannot get Elvish Brig. I only play two. And I already drew both of them. I only have one Dates backup now. Dress down. Dress down means that wait, that kills their construct. Never seen Saga and Dresdown in the same. And it did target myself. Not a very card advantage play, but at least we're in dead. Huh? Is, I mean, if they had a Dresdown or is a Saga, okay. They played Delver of Secret. It's the worst of the shapes on. Well, defense grade is there. Guess I'm counting it. I really thought the game was over. They just forced my. Okay, force they just. Okay, I want to play Chain of Smog. Because I'm on 11, so like, it's not that I lose. Yeah, no, I think I'm holding. I think I'm holding the chain. I came for 4 here. What did I do? Because every time I'm playing a spell, it drains full heart. Oh, that's good now. Well, I can Chainless Mog you. But then, like, my ult this deck only wins if I combo, so. Reveal date. Also glad I didn't go for chain swap. I mean, days was the preordain top. Good. Set. Auto. up Erdane. Bad. Lands are kind of awkward. I don't know when I got that by you. Maybe I just drew it or maybe I fetch it. Wasteland. Great. Well, there is the comp. Although I'm looking for a land here. Around I'll play Witchblood Talisman. They daze this, I'm okay. Is that I don't have to play around daze next turn? Three mana? Brazen Bar, alright, I'm dead. Bar of it. Now sideboard against the blue or red cards. Still on Safekeeper. I'm fine here. I think yeah, main deck must be like kind of optimized for the blue red decks. They are very popular in Legacy. I did download the deck that went 5-0, so from a player that used to play this archetype. I'm sure I made plenty of mistakes in this league. Long. By mistake, I don't mean that. As in this. Mistaken actual game plan. Alright, I'll be keeping this hand. It is a little bit land heavy, but lands are definitely important. I'm just going to rest. And Dave's brainstorm Lightning Bolt. Well, I'm gonna take Lightning Bolt. Since, yeah, something to be concerned about. I want to. I think I'll play this Witchblood Talisman now. Pass. Now they have Brazen Bar to bounce my creature if I attempt to win. Alright, draw, brainstorm, okay, I can cast it. Duress. The one doesn't take Brazen Bar, unfortunately. okay, well, but it's not the worst, huh? Let me think. Because I can go Summoner's Pact for, well, I certainly don't think I can win now, but next turn I can't win, huh? I wanna go do rest here. They have you know, Witchblood. This one can get Sylvan Safekeeper, this one can get the other one. Go brainstorm. Oh, me. Yeah, so I'll probably hide their best card. You're also supposed to keep your rest for the following turn. It's fine. You know? Lightning Bolt was definitely the card I'm afraid about. Afraid. Okay, now. Now they played the land and passed. And I'm going. Dark Rachel. Knew about that. Okay, now can I go? Can I win? Well, I can certainly play around days, I'm pretty sure. Pick it up. I feel like I want out. Let me just recount. I have one, I go get the two drop. I have three, four, five. I do have enough. Do I have enough? I don't think I have enough actually. Because I have three, four, five, and I need five, so the days will still work. I guess I do need the top card here. Four. I have six, I spend one, then I have five. Yeah, it's fine, I'm passing here. Need another. They bounce my Wish Clock Talisman, that's fine. Tough life out here, but we do beat next turn days and the burn spells. Maybe that is why I wasn't supposed to go after Lightning Bolt when I did on turn one. I was supposed to go after Brainstorm. I draw the Petal, and now I'm going. As I go get the Whithering Apprentice, I play Summoner's Pact. Did it in disorder because that's only sorceries. Elusive Keeper, play it. I suppose the Dark Rachel. Anyway, the Dark Rachel. Go with more Apprentice. Change those Mogami with Day's backup, so we have it all. We have it all covered, other than Force of Will. We have it all covered. Sacrifice all entire creature gains Shroud. We got all the bases covered. The one that we know about, the Bolt and Brazen Bar and Daze. Third Brainstorm, that's okay. I need to do this first because this is only sorcery. So if they bounce this in response to anything else I'm doing, yeah, also I need to do this first because this gives Shroud to itself. Think we're good to win here if they don't find a Force of Will or Force of Negation or another Daze or a Colossal Storm. There's a lot of things they can find. The last match of the league. Okay. What do you do? Rude Slay. Red. Oh, I'm giving this. Tapping a red, I am already giving this. In case you didn't know, this is an old invitational card. Called Rade. From Sweden. Card that he designed. Press down. I have to target my opponent and sorry. So now I need to discard two cards at least. Hey, not at winning, but I could. My top deck is fresh. So. For the Days in Delver. Hey, I'll pass. Now they have the Wishclaw Talisman. This is an artifact, so the construct is slightly larger. Oh, I forgot about Summoner's Pond. Alright, that's it for me. Thank you guys and girls for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll be back next week with another Legacy video! Thank you. Have a good day, everybody. Write a comment in the chat if you do. And, you know, say, Mango, you shouldn't play blah 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 blah. I know. But what am I supposed to play? Want to see a Ragavan? Sure, I guess I could do that. Thank you, everybody. See you next time.